welcome my dear students. Today we are going to start with our English lesson, that is The Last Class, written by Alphonse Daudet. I will introduce you to the topic. The narration of this story is by French boy Franz. Franz is a lazy boy. However, in spite of being lazy, he likes to play and he is sensitive in nature. Mr. Hamel is his school teacher and he teaches him French, but Franz does not have any interest in learning French. An order has come from Berlin after taking over the district of Alsace and Lorraine in France, that the German language rather than the French should be taught in the school. Furthermore, it is the school French teacher Mr. Hamel's last day. This teacher has been working there for 40 years. Moreover, the teacher has feeling of patriotism. He is also full of nostalgia and grief. The village men also attended the last lesson so as to honor him and respect him. The village is regretting and is sad that they did not learn their mother tongue in their childhood. Franz receives a big shock when he learns that this is his last lesson in French. He is shocked because he does not know French. Furthermore, on learning about the last lesson, a sudden interest arises in him for learning French. Moreover, he pays careful attention and learns everything taught on his last day. Instantly, he develops a liking for the teacher, Mr. Hamel. His feeling for hatred suddenly comes to an end. Moreover, Franz develops respect for the hard work and sincerity of his teacher. Franz is sad and ashamed for being unable to recite the lesson. Mr. Hamel explains that they all are at fault for lacking eagerness to learn. He also includes himself to aid this fault. He blames himself for lack of sincerity in teaching them. There is a reflection of his patriotism in his praise for the French language. He says that the French language is the most logical and beautiful language in the world. It seems that Mr. Hamel got emotional on this occasion. Furthermore, he asks the class to guard their language. He says that being close to one's language is a way to escape the clutches of slavery. The people realize the significance of their language, of their mother tongue. Moreover, they feel the reason for their defeat is illiteracy. Franz feels that it is impossible to remove one's language from a person. This is because it is something that is natural to a person. This means that no matter how hard the opposition may try, they will fail to remove one's language. Now, from this, what conclusion can be drawn? We can conclude that the last lesson reflects on the importance of one's language for any race and why it is crucial to safeguard it. Now let us talk about the author Alphonse Daudet. Alphonse Daudet is also known as Louis Marie Alphonse Daudet. He was born on 13th May 1840 and died on 16th December 1897. He was a French novelist. His work revolved around the provincial life in south of France. His popular works include The Monday Tales, Kings in Exile, and Letters from Manville. He has received awards like Knight of the Legion of Honor, Officer of the Legion of Honor. Now here, the Prussian force under the Bismarck attacked France in the year 1870. All the Germans stood by Prussia and France was defeated. The France district of Arras and Lorraine passed into Prussian lands. Prussian rules disallowed the teaching of French in the school of these two districts. The French teacher in these schools were asked to leave. This story describes the last day of one such teacher in this school. He gives his last lesson to his students with as much determination and sincerity as ever. This brings out the pathos of the whole situation and also depicts the quiet dignity of the French teacher named Mr. Hamel. Let us discuss some main points, whatever we are going to learn in this lesson. It is the story of a school teacher who taught French in district of French. The district has been captured by Prussian, that is German army. All teaching of the French language was disallowed in schools of this district. French teachers were asked to leave their schools. This story describes the last lesson of one such teacher. The story is narrated by a little student named Franz in the teacher's class. Little Franz was late for school that morning. He was afraid that the teacher would scold him. He was also afraid because the teacher was to ask questions on participles and he didn't know a word about them. The little Franz thought of running away and spending the day out of doors. He saw the Prussians, the soldiers, drilling in the open field. Watching them seemed to him to be far more tempting than the rule for participle. However, he hurried off to school. On his way, little Franz passed by the town hall. He saw a crowd of people in front of the bulletin board. When little Franz reached his school, it was all quiet. There were none of the usual noises. It was quiet as Sunday morning. All his classmates were already on their seats. The teacher, Mr. Hamel, was walking up and down. He had his terrible iron ruler under his arm. Little Franz opened the door and went in. He was very frightened, but to his surprise, Mr. Hamel said very kindly, "Go to your place quickly, little Franz." Franz saw that the teacher was in one of the best dresses, the one he wore only on inspections or prize days. And at the back of the class, the village people were sitting quietly. Everybody looked sad. Franz wondered what it was all about. Mr. Hamel began in a very grave and gentle tone. "My children, this last lesson I shall give you.
The order has come from Berlin to teach only German in the school of Alsace and Lorraine. The new master comes tomorrow. This is your last French lesson. I want you to be very attentive. Now, for the first time, little Franz began to feel sorry for not being serious in his lessons. He was also sad that he would never see Mr. Hamel again. He forgot all about his ruler and crunchy nature. Now, Franz understood why Mr. Hamel was in his best clothes. He also understood why the old men of the village were sitting there. They had come to show their respect to Mr. Hamel's 40 years of faithful service. Mr. Hamel asked to recite the rule of participles. Franz got mixed up on the first words, but Mr. Hamel did not scold him. He only said, "You pretend to be Frenchmen and yet you can't speak nor write your own language. But you are not the worst, little Franz. We have all a great deal to reproach ourselves with." Then he spoke in details about the Franz languages and said that it was all the best language in the world. Mr. Hamel opened a grammar book and gave his last lesson to the class. Little Franz was amazed to see that he understood every word of it. Mr. Hamel explained with great patience. After the grammar, he gave a practice in writing. While the students were busy with their writings, Mr. Hamel gazed at everything in the classroom. It was as if he wanted to fix everything in his mind. It must have broken his heart to think that he was to leave it all. All at once, the church clock struck 12. The sounds of midday prayer were heard. At the same moment, the trumpets of the Prussian returning from drill were heard. Mr. Hamel stood up to say something but couldn't. He was choked with emotions. He took a piece of chalk and wrote on the blackboard as large as he could, "Long live France." Thank you.